Mom and Dad, two kids. Just a few short decades ago, the majority of Americans lived in the traditional family. Today, the same can be said for only one quarter of American households. They called our generation the baby boom. An unprecedented 77 million of us were born between 1946 and 1964. The result is the graying of America. Where a baby boomer turns 50 every 7 seconds. What's our definition of mainstream? It was the Beatles, Robert Redford, and Meryl Streep. It's now not just Britney Spears, but Jennifer Lopez, Ricky Martin, and Christina Aguilera. Hispanics are the fastest growing segment of the population. And Hispanics, African Americans, and Asian Americans will comprise half of our population in the coming decades. In the 1960s, entertainment was movies and colored television, and viewing was limited to three national networks. Entertainment today is home computers, in-home theaters, MP3 players, PlayStation 2, DVDs, and DirecTV.
Satellite, huh?
With more than 500 channels playing simultaneously. And some say there's still nothing on. The great American love affair with cars exploded with the introduction of the Ford Mustang. The Mustang set a first-year sales record of 418,214 units sold. The sticker price? $2,368. A comparably equipped 2001 Mustang GT? $24,480. More than 10 times its original price. In 1964, the big news in automotive technology was automatic climate control.
The year the first Suburban was introduced was a simpler time. Unless, of course, you locked your keys in the car. In that case, the simpler time would be now.
OnStar, how can I help you?
Yeah, I locked my keys in the car.
Oh, no problem.
In 2001, it's global positioning systems, in-vehicle video and game systems, and the advent of telematics, from parallel parking distance sensors to voice-activated control panels. Toyota introduced the first Japanese car to the U.S. in 1957, the Toyo Pet Crown. Datsun followed a year later. Total sales of Japanese cars that year in the U.S., 1,612. In 2000, nearly 4 million Japanese cars and light trucks were sold in the U.S. Oldsmobile introduced the Hydromatic transmission, the first fully automatic transmission in 1940. The Hydromatic was a $57 option. Oldsmobile opened the gates for acceptance of the automatic transmission, with more than 90% of cars sold today featuring automatics. I can recall. In 1994, hydraulic transmissions began phasing out with the advent of OBD2. The newest electronic transmissions constantly feed data on transmission status, operating conditions, and even operator behavior to the onboard computer. In fact, there are more electronics in a car today than there were in Apollo 9. Rear-wheel drive ruled for nearly 80 years. But with the onset of the oil crisis in 1973, the drive for fuel efficiency created the transition to front-wheel drive. The boom in light trucks and SUVs brought further change, popularizing four-wheel and all-wheel drive. In fact, over one half of new vehicles sold today are SUVs, minivans, or light trucks.
Friends, go in
In the 1960s, thousands of young automotive enthusiasts chose auto mechanics as a profession. Today, transmission technicians need an understanding of electronics and the skills to work on more than 180 transmission units. So today's technicians come from a variety of backgrounds, and we compete for the attention of a generation raised on video games and with more interest in electronics than automotive careers. Change is inevitable, yet change can be a positive. Consider these changes. The number of cars and light trucks in use in the U.S. grew 18% during the last decade. The average age of passenger cars in use in the U.S. steadily increases year after year, rising from a little more than 6 years in use as recently as 1980 to more than 9 years in use by the year 2000. After declining in the late 1980s and early 1990s, car and truck sales have been on a record-setting pace for the last 8 years, leading to an increase in the number of vehicles 7 to 10 years of age, the age where vehicles are most likely to require transmission repairs. AAMCO dealers will benefit most from these positive changes, as the AAMCO brand name has become an American icon, recognized by 98% of the driving public.
AAMCO, double A, MC.
Hey, it's a stop sign over here, okay?
What are you doing?
We're honking these
That was the radio, Larry. Where's the radio?
Hey, what are you, nuts?
I thought he beat me.
Have you ever heard that commercial before? Double A, beep, beep, MCO. Everyone's heard that commercial. Larry, AAMCO, double A, beep, beep, MCO.
If you are willing to accept change, you can be like dozens of AAMCO dealers who have embraced the changes in our business and have flourished. They have accepted that today's transmission technicians are different than in the past. They have accepted that today's AAMCO Center must be clean, up to date, and appeal to a customer base that is increasingly female. They have accepted that transmissions have become more sophisticated, and they use the proper diagnostic procedures to do all that they can to ensure the transmissions are fixed right the first time. And today's dealer has changed the way they market their center to be in tune with a changing consumer and a changing marketplace. One person can look at the ever-increasing complexity of the modern transmission and think, how will I ever find technicians who can work on these units? While another sees instead the opportunities when fewer and fewer competitors will work on these sophisticated units, leaving AAMCO dealers with a larger section of a growing market. Yes, there are obstacles, but today you will learn of many ways to overcome these obstacles. Are you ready? Gear up for 2002.